Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. In these videos, I always emphasize oral administration of drugs. Let's talk about why oral dosing is preferred while we acknowledge other routes of administration. The gold standard for most new drugs is oral administration or oral delivery with once per day dosing. Some of the benefits and best case scenarios for oral dosing are on the screen. Oral dosing is very convenient for the patient. Very advantageous for repeated dosing because the patient can administer the dose. Oral pills also tend to store very well. They have great shelf life. The drug, however, must be bioavailable, has to be stable to the GI tract and cross cell membranes. This last bullet point is a tough hurdle. The successful oral drug must do more than just work, it must work under the constraint of being bioavailable. What other options are there? The FDA recognizes over 100 routes of administration. Intravenous administration is a big one. I reference the IV bolus, which is administration over a short, maybe 1 to 3 minute window. I reference the IV bolus a lot. The IV push is similar. It's really an instantaneous injection into an IV port. The IV infusion is a slow release and can occur over an hour or even longer. Intravenous administration is great. Bioavailability is 100% by definition because the drug is administered directly into the central compartment. On the downside, injections often require a healthcare professional to be present. That adds cost. You can also have infection risks. Still, since patients for some conditions will likely be in a hospital, having an IV port and assistance for the injection may not be an issue. Other routes may be preferred based on the required site of action, the location of the drug target. A nasal spray is perfect for seasonal allergy treatment. There's no reason to expose the entire body to levels of a drug if the site of action can be focused upon with a nasal spray. Inhalers for asthma drugs only affect the lungs. Topical lotions are excellent for many skin conditions. All these options avoid systemic exposure and potentially the related safety risks. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please relay any questions you might have in the comment section below. Also, consider subscribing and/or liking. Take care.